Learn how to work with your Power Apps directly from Visual Studio Code in this episode of Azure Tips and Tricks. The Power Platform enables business users to rapidly create low-code applications. Sometimes developers need to augment and customize these applications. In this video, we'll take a look at how developers can do that with the Power Platform VS Code extension. Let's start by creating a new portal app. All right. First, I'll give this a name, like this. And now also an address. You use this to navigate to the app. And finally, I'll change the language. Okay, create. This will take a while, so I'll skip to when it is done. Here we are. This is the portal app in the Power Apps Studio. Business users can change the portal website from here using UI editors. And this is what the website looks like. Cool. Let's go back. In here, there is a settings menu, and this is the portal admin center. Okay, we need this URL later on, so let's copy it. All right. Here we are in Visual Studio Code. I'll go to the extensions menu here. And in here, search for Power Platform VS Code extension. There it is. And install it. Okay, that's it. The extension offers autocomplete, the Power Platform CLI, and more. We'll use the Power Platform CLI to download and upload the portal app. Here we go. First, I need to authenticate to the portal Microsoft Dataverse environment. There it goes. I'll enter my credentials, and that's it. Okay. Next, let's see the portal apps that I have. Okay. Cool. I'll need this ID in the next command. This one. This one downloads the contents of the portal to this path. Okay, there it goes. And that's it. Now I can open the folder with the portal contents like this. And here it is. These are all the portal files. Pretty cool. And from here, I can open and edit all of them. This is very useful for more advanced customization. Let's keep it simple with this HTML file. This is the About page, and I can preview it here. Let's change this slightly to this. Okay, I'll save the file, and that's it. All I need to do now is to upload the contents to the Power Platform. I'll do that from the terminal with the Power Platform CLI, with this command. This points to the Portal Contents folder. All right, that should be it. Let's take a look. Okay, here is the portal website. And go to the About page. Yes, it's changed from VS Code. With the Power Platform Visual Studio Code extension, software developers can work on the same Power Apps as business users. Go and check it out.